In this video, you're going to learn how to build a plant identification app just like this, designed really nicely using bolt.new, which is an AI tool that helps you write code and build apps for yourself. So I'm going to show you what it looks like. We have some really cool animations here, hover animations. We're going to identify this plant. It's going to analyze it. And then within a couple seconds, here we have our result. So it's using OpenAI to take the image and get us the result here. Be sure to check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA's Coding with AI course to learn even more about how to do things like this. Now let's get into the video. So we're in Bolt, and I'm going to type what I want to build, which is a plant identification app using AI. And it's going to create an outline and start building. And as you can see, it is literally writing the code for us right away. It's setting up the entire app. So it's installing dependencies, creating everything that is needed to kind of get started. And this is where you don't have to know how to code to understand or kind of build this type of app. It's going to do it all for you. It's going to set up all of the kind of initial setup that if you didn't know how to code would be really difficult. So it says, I've created a plant identification app with the following features: camera integration, TensorFlow, a clean UI with loading indicators, support for five common plant types. And then it's saying that it wants me to train a model and convert it to TensorFlow. So right off the bat, there's a few things that I want to change based on what I know about this app and what I want to build. So I'm going to say, let's do the identification with OpenAI instead, so we don't have to use TensorFlow. And for this web app, instead of using a camera, let the user just upload an image. So let's make it a little bit simpler, and then let's use OpenAI, since I know that Vision API is going to do a really good job with this. So we're going to let it do that. Now it's going to follow my instructions and keep building based on what I shared. So I'm going to pause the video, let it build it out, and I'll unpause it once it is ready. Okay, so it created this landing page, but I want this to be fully within the web app. So I'm going to say, instead of a landing page, can you just give me a page or to go to the app page with the app itself directly? No need for QR code or links to App Store. And let's see what it does here. Okay, so after some back and forth where I kind of had to keep telling it that I'm seeing the QR code on the page and I just want an interface to upload an image and identify the plant, it made some changes, and now it's switched it from a native script to a web-based React application. So now I should be able to upload an image of a plant and get it to identify. So it's saying there's a few things I need to do. One is replace your OpenAI key in the app.tsx file with an actual OpenAI API key. So let's go to code app.tsx. So right here, I need to put my OpenAI key. And then we should be able to upload, and let's see what happens. So I'm going to grab an API key, going to generate a Bolt test, and then I'll delete it afterwards. So I'll copy this, paste this in right here. And then let's go back to the preview and let's upload an image here. Okay, so I've uploaded an image of a plant here, and let's click identify and see what happens. It looks like there might be an issue. Error, incorrect API key. No, it definitely is the correct key because I just put it in. So I'm going to say it definitely is the correct API key because I just put it in. So let's see what happens here. And maybe the issue was I just didn't maybe refresh it after I put in the API key or didn't save it. That's one thing that I can think of. So now let's see if it works again. All right, so let's go down. Let's click Identify Plant. It says analyzing my plants, but I'm also seeing there's some issues here. So I'm just going to say fix problems. So it should know there's a problem. And it's going to fix it to the right model name. Okay, so maybe that was the issue here. All right, so let's try this again. I chose the file. Let's click Identify Plant. And there is another issue, model not found. Okay, so let's fix the problem here. Okay, so I think it's just using the wrong model. I'm gonna say, I think you should be using GPT-40-mini. Because that's just from looking at the documentation here in OpenAI, that is what I'm seeing. So let's have it update that and see what happens. And this is where you have to kind of read documentation. Sometimes, you know, something might not be working and Bolt won't know, and you have to go and actually read the documentation and see what might be happening. I hope you update it. It says now it's using GPT-4 Vision Preview. It just doesn't know. So I think it just does, it's not aware of the newest model. So I'm going to say, I don't think you're aware of the newest models. Please use GPT-40 Mini. Okay, so this is interesting. So it's not listening to me when I'm saying that they're the new model. I'm going to say you just haven't learned about it. Please proceed with the example. Proceed based off the example API call I shared, which I shared just the example from the documentation. Let's see if it works. Don't suggest a different model right now. All right, so let's see what it says here. So it says it's going to try, though I should note this is experimental. Okay. So now there seemed to be an issue with launching the app, and I'm having it fix that setup. Okay, so I kept running into these issues of command fails for launching the app, so I sold it to update the app so it's simpler and launches, so you don't keep running into these same issues. Okay, cool. So that actually worked. So let me upload the file again and see what happens. All right, let's identify the plant, see if this works. Analyzing the plant, analyzing the plant. Amazing. Okay, so it actually did work here. It says the plant is a rubber plant, description, family native to Southeast Asia. Okay, very cool. So let me upload another file and see how it does. So here I just went to a page of the 50 most common house plants, for example. So why don't I take a screenshot of this? And let's see how well it does. So I'm going to upload that. So this is the jade plant. And let's identify it and see if it gets it correct. Amazing. Okay, so this is the jade plant. This was the kind of technical name. And yeah, awesome. So we're getting information accurately from OpenAI just from this image. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is, can you style this app? Let's say, can you style this app using the style guidelines from Spotify, but keep the same functionality. Don't add any new functionality. Just update the styles. So I want it to look good, and let's see if it kind of does this like dark style design aesthetic. So let's see what happens here. All right, cool. So after a little back and forth where it wasn't doing it and I had to kind of ask why not, it did it, and here we go. So now we have like a really cool little app here that looks really nice. And This is just where using examples is really helpful. So I said, you know, do it in the style of Spotify. And even though it's an app nothing like Spotify, it still made it look really nice. So let me upload a file. Why don't we pick a different plant? Why don't we do this lucky bamboo? It's kind of cool. So I will take a screenshot here and then let me upload it. All right, already it looks really cool with the animation. Let's click identify plant. I love that, how it kind of opens up like that. Analyzing. So this looks amazing. I'm really, really impressed. And there we go. The plant in the image is commonly known as lucky bamboo. And it has some descriptions. So I'm sure we could format this a little bit better. But overall, this is awesome. So let's just see. Let's do one more thing. See if we can make that formatted. So let's say this is great. The result format is showing like this. Can we make it so it looks nice and formatted with bold, etc.? So I think we basically just need to make this rich text. So it's going to do it in markdown style. Yeah, markdown. So I'll pause it, let it build that real quick. Okay, so let's pick another plant here. Why don't we do this umbrella plant? That's kind of cool. So I'm going to take a screenshot. Let's go back. So here we have the plant uploaded. Let's click identify plant, analyzing, and amazing. Wow. This looks really, really good. So the plant in your image is, I can't even pronounce that, but referred to as umbrella plant. And it just does a really cool job with the markdown formatting here. So I'm really impressed. We can even make it bigger. But that is really, really cool. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something. I'm really impressed by what Bolt can do and what Bolt built here. Be sure to check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA's Coding with AI course, where you're going to learn even more in-depth things like this in a lot more detail. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content like this. We'll see you in the next video.